You're not going to come out and say goodbye, mate? Stay in your box, you unsociable bugger. See you later, Pink.
I am excited. Actually, that's a bloody understatement. I am ultra excited. The truck is completely full to the top with everything you can imagine for a 10-day mission. I've got four guns in there, three rifles and one gun, making them a 14. Camera gear. This is a holiday that has a lot of meaning for me, a lot more than most holidays. Those of you on my Patreon have been following my life will know why. I won't go into the details, but at least to say, I wasn't really quite sure I was even going to be having this holiday, but I am, and I'm taking you with me. Oh, I'm just doing the idiot check right now because I'm just about to leave. Have I got everything? Probably not. It's taken me 2 days to pack. I've got white bait stuff on the top for doing white baiting. I've got trout fishing gear. I've got all my pig hunting stuff and all my camera gear. I've got, yeah, like fly rods, spinning rods, licenses, permits, cameras, fuel, food, dog tucker. The list goes on and on. I'm just walking around doing the very final idiot check before we hit the road. I'm pretty sure I've got everything, but probably left something behind. And my daughter's going to look after these dogs. Actually, Patrick's going to probably take B away and hunt him. Took B away yesterday and he bailed up a 120-pound boar. Patrick didn't take his rifle, did he? See, he got a bail up going on there, really good bail up. And nothing to bloody well shoot it with. Want to do that again, eh, Patrick? See you later, old mate. Hey, you got a good boy, eh? Anybody comes, just eat them, yeah? Destroy all the evidence, just eat the whole lot. Yeah, good boy. That's if you can wake up. Good boy, Bruno. It's a good dog. You look after my chainsaw there too, eh? Last time somebody stole that, it actually came back to us within 3 days. We got it back. That's a story in itself. I think I've told you guys that story. Right, stop the yakker and get on the road. Hope you enjoy the video. See you down the line. Two very excited young men, Cuzzy Bro and Blake. I'll be meeting them down in the bay and hopefully getting them onto some, well, all sorts of things. Who can say what lies ahead? I don't even know myself. I'm going to uncharted territory for me. Places where my father used to hunt up the Jacob. He hunted all around there when he was a young man, and I've always wanted to go there, and I'm making it happen. Hopefully I can make it good for the two young fellas too. My thinking is this: if you don't make someone else's life better, then you're wasting your own. Okay, enough of my opinions. We'll get out of this farm and get to the West Coast. See you later, sheep. Might see one of you want to get back for a bit of a cook-up. Currently we are in the town of Greymouth on the west coast of the South Island of New Zealand, and it's a grey day. Not surprising, it's why it's called Greymouth. Often it's grey here. And Pace has a new seat. Not supposed to be there, but he somehow made his way up there. I was going to meet my son here, but he's off on a mission, which he often does. Probably rafting or kayaking or climbing or God knows what. He'll do something over here exciting. So I'm going to press on down the west coast to Hawketickle, will be my next stop, where I may stop and have something to munch on. But if you're lucky, I may give you something to munch on too. Just come out of the township of Hawketickle. It's a neat little town, Hawketickle. I like it there. And from Hawketickle down south to South Westland, it's some of the most beautiful scenery you'll see. I mean, right now I've only got farm on each side, but as we get down further, we're getting into native bush on both sides. It really is beautiful. So I'm going to stop off and have a cup of tea with Josh that lives in Ross. According to my navigation system here, I'm not too far away from him, just over halfway. I actually ran into his lovely wife and his son in the car park while I was buying my veggies at New World. Looking forward to having a catch up with you, Josh. Been too long, mate. Life goes fast. So if you don't know Josh, Josh is a YouTuber known as the Kiwi Bushman, and he's a good bastard, really a genuine bloke, and has a great channel. Check it out if you haven't already. And we sort of live along similar lines, doing similar things, but I'm a filthy pig hunter and he's more of a artful, dodgy deer stalker. Shoots a few tar and chamois. Josh works as a raft guide. He's got, well, he has his own company. I think it's called Eco Rafting. Don't quote me on that, I'm just thinking back, but my memory's a bit shit these days. And Josh, like me, is on a ketogenic diet, so I have bought him some cauliflower plants to put in his vegetable garden, because if you're on the keto diet, cauliflower is a cool vegetable to have, because it kind of doubles up, not really, but as rice. You call it cauliflower rice, because you can't have rice or carbohydrate on the keto diet, cauliflower is a good thing you can replace rice with, and also make like crusts for pizza stuff. I mean, it's not the same, but it's as good as. So I bought him some plants. According to my nav set, we're not too far away at all. Just about in the township of Ross already.
There's Fox Glacier.
Okay.
You'll go past here, you'll keep going here, you'll go past the Cook River.
Well, that was really bloody awesome. Just leaving Josh's place now. And I didn't film it because I just wanted to have some man time. I'm not really in YouTube making video state of mind right now on this trip. I'm offline and I'm not really thinking about it probably like I should as a YouTuber. Sometimes it's nice to just leave the camera and the truck, and that's what I did. So might see him on the way back down and do a mission if I've got any energy and time left. But just great to catch up with you, Josh. Always love talking with people like open-minded people like Josh. I've got a lot of respect for Josh and what he does and how he is and how he operates. I find him very honest and very helpful. He's steered me in the right direction a few places. I could go for a deer or a chamois, which I appreciate. A lot of hunters don't do that. He's very supportive. A lot of hunters are sort of feel like they have to compete, whereas Josh is the opposite. He supports.
This song is for the craziest girl, Bruce Bay. Wajalina, have you seen her? Have you seen her? No, no. I said, Jalina, have you seen her? Yes, I've seen her. There she goes. She got big brown eyes and a great big smile, and she makes everybody's time worthwhile. What, Jalina, have you seen her? Yeah, I seen her go by. She's lazy, oh so lazy, X real crazy, oh yeah. She won't go for a run, but she likes to have her fun. Jalina, that's the one. Last time. What, Jalina?
She says something crazy.
What do you mean? You talking about me? Don't sing, Jalina. Doesn't sound so good. And why am I sounding like a Jamaican when I am playing my ukulele out of time? But Jalina, you still got a big, big smile. Last time. What? You got to sing with me too.
Okay.
What, Jalina? What, Jalina? What, Jalina? What are the words?
Have you seen her?
Ah, oh, okay, yeah, what, Jalina? Have you seen her? Have you seen her? That girl, your turn. What,
Jalina? Oh, Jalina. Have you seen her? What is it now?
That girl. That's the first version of it. We'll work on that.
Yeah.
This is what you caught, is it? You hunted it?
Yeah, I did.
No, you didn't. It's roadkill. We're going to take the skin off for you. Is this going to be a hat for you, Jalina, or for...
Yeah, for me.
For you, okay. Will it be a pink hat like the one you got now? Your diet pink?
No, and that will be my purse.
What, the possum's balls will be your purse?
Yeah. Figure out how to go inside
the hole. So Jalina's kept the nuts, these nuts,
yeah,
to make a nice purse.
Yeah, so the kids won't steal my money anymore.
I can tell you right now that nobody's going to want to touch your money once they've been in that purse, Jalina.
Not telling you.
Waste not, what not. Roadkill around here gets used, eh, Jalina?
Yeah. I caught them.
You didn't catch that.
Yeah.
You did not catch that. Beside me is young Blake, he's 14 years of age, and in the back is Cuzzy, who's also 14. Got a nice grass flat just over here. The plant
getting a pretty good lash through the bush, come back out onto the river. I'd say we're going to be going back without any meat today. We're heading back, boys. Just keep your eyes open all the time. It's just a wind and remember. We had the wind in our advantage to get around the river. It's coming down. But anything down here will smelt us by now. Ah, good adventure, anyway.
Obviously, we're back at the truck. Obviously, we're wet. Obviously, we're cold. And obviously, we didn't get any blood on our knives. But, what's that, mate?
Not today.
Not today. Well, the day's not over yet. Still this evening. But that's this hunt. I'm going to ask the boys what they gained from this hunt, other than getting wet asses and cold. You cold?
Yeah, oh, not too bad, really.
Not too bad. You, no. Cuzzy?
Not too bad.
Not too bad. So we had the right gear, and that's the whole thing. There's no such thing as bad weather, only...
inadequate clothing.
Yeah, that's the one. So, what did you gain from this?
Oh, probably just, before you go into an area, just sort of talk to some other people, ask them about what to expect, really.
Well, we had that info on the paper. We had that, and we were put in the right place, and there was animals there.
Yeah.
I think the thing that you probably should have gained from it was about your optics.
Oh, right, yeah, getting some caps for that, or...
Yeah. A lot of guys that go on, you know, without, protection over your optics and also gear for wiping it.
Yeah.
Toilet paper's no good, and a wee rag's no good. You've got to have the right gear for that. So, Cuzzy, did you learn anything other than getting a wet bum and catching nothing?
Making sure we knew where we came from.
Yep.
And going back the same way and making marks.
Yep, so we talked about the, there's no such thing as a sense of direction. There's only such a thing as a sense of observation, observing where you come, where you go. And I marked a couple of trees when we came out. We actually came out a different way, and it wasn't a big walk, to be honest. We only probably walked in an hour, so it wasn't a massive one. But if we'd gone a couple of hours, you could have easily got lost, eh?
Yeah.
This is a batch that we've hired. Well, I haven't hired it, actually. David and Jelena and friends have hired it. That's their son there, Blake, making pancakes. And I come along as a guest. And out across the road, we're in Bruce Bay, right down South Westland. Poe and Pace are inside. They've come with me. This is our view, and as you can see, there's a whole load of tourists. This place constantly has tourists here all the time. They look like they're Asian or some, I don't know, whether Chinese or Japanese. I can never tell, I'm not very good with that. But all the time there's someone there checking it out. And today is a bloody good day. It's been raining all the time. Gives me a real appreciation for people on the coast, how they do stuff. Over here's my nifty raft, which yesterday Blake and I took across Lake Moraki and caught a couple of trout. Last night we went up the back of those mountains right up there for a deer and spooked a couple, but didn't find any on the clearing where we were going to go. Pace, Poe. Come. There's something on that tire, they keep smelling another dog. Come on. There's a highway here, so you're not staying outside. Poe, come. She's winding a pig. Poe, come. Good boy, Pace. Coming in? Take your time. So it's been a real break from internet, from YouTube, from making videos, which has been really good because it's given me a time to reflect stuff. We also brought young Cuzzy down with us. He left, he was quite crook. Everybody got the man flu. How are you feeling now, Blakus?
Yeah, it's alright.
Yeah, Blake's been pretty sick. He's been pretty brave. What's going on over here? I'm just zoning in the cooking. He's got something written on them. What's that?
I think it's just the date that they were laid.
Are these the eggs that my mother gave you from her?
Probably, yeah.
From her chickens. He's making pancakes. That one there's got quite a white yolk, isn't it?
Yeah.
Bit suspicious. Nah, be right. Sweet as, bro. And tonight we're having duck. The best duck in the world. It was gifted to me by a good bastard. Gave me four, actually. So I'll report back a bit later on with a bit more of the snap vlog just to let you know what's going on here. We're enjoying our holiday and we don't want to go home. We don't want to go back to reality. We want to go back to work. We want to go back to
the same old, because every day here we either go white baiting, fishing, hunting, fossicking along the beach, bushwalks, and it's just like a holiday you don't want to end, but like all holidays have to come to an end soon. I'm really glad I took Poe and Pace with me too. Oh, yesterday, B caught a pig, so I left B at home with Dayla, but I've got a few mates looking after them, like Simon and Patrick and different guys looking after the place. And Patrick took B out and caught a pig yesterday, so they're getting some hunting in. You see a few white bait down there? Check this out. Imagine if you've got a chainsaw and you cut that off at ground level, have that in your living room as a wee table, you can sit around and have schnapps or cups of coffee or other chemicals that you enjoy participating in, like tea. Just a thought, what do you reckon? The wind in my favour, coming this side here. Animals are likely to come out, scrub over here. In front I've got some nice open grass. It's that hour animals start to move, so I'm not going to move, I'm just going to be absolutely dead quiet. Got me mate Ricky Brown's 308 suppressed. I'm using my pig hunting GPS so I don't get myself lost, because I'm hunting where I've never been before. The Alpha 100, so I've just marked my track and come out onto this clearing, which I'm thinking is probably a place that once had a lot of native plants and has been milled. It's not farm clearings, it's Department of Conservation land. Deep in South Westland, I'm about 10 kilometres from Bruce Bay, and the wind is perfect, so all I need now is an animal to come out in the next 20 minutes because it'll be dark soon. We'll see how we go. Currently cruising and thinking about Kenny Aykroyd. Kenny died last week. I played a lot of music with Kenny. Kenny taught me a hell of a lot. Told me some pretty interesting stories too about his life. And just cruising along here on the West Coast thinking about Ken. His funeral's this Wednesday. I'm going to head on back to Nelson there. And I'm going to head on down to Christchurch. We play a lot of shows, Kenny and I. I don't know how good we really were. We supported John Hammond Jr. UB40 was a... I was supposed to do that with Kenny, but I ended up... I can't remember. Something went wrong that night. I missed that concert. BB King, we met him. We did quite a few supports for different artists. But we really, really just wanted to play the blues. And we didn't really care whether we were playing... where we were playing. We'd just play anywhere. And we used to play for free quite often, and often would also get paid good money. The gangs in Christchurch used to support us quite a bit, paid us with their drug money and their prostitution money and the extortion money or wherever it was it came from, I don't know. We just took cash in hand and did the gig. It's pretty hard out gigs.
used to play for the Highway 61s at the pad in, was it Worcester Street? Can't even remember now, so many years ago. Good times though. So he's gone. He passed away. And I'm reflecting on Kenny. We played some shows on radio. And we played in the Green Door Blues. The Green Door was one pub or a club, a private club, run by a bloke called Hippie back then. There was the Blues Club, the Southern Blues Club in Christchurch. We played there, but we also played a Main Street Cafe. Grant, that used to own the Main Street Cafe, did a live show with us on radio once. And we played in lots of places. We played in places where we didn't even get paid just because we wanted to play. But we always used to drink whiskey. And our band was called Bad Whiskey. And that's what we were. We were like playing just blues. And it was a good band. It wasn't really a band, it was a duo. He played 12-string guitar and I played harmonica and sung. Kenny taught me a lot about how to entertain. One of the songs we used to sing was Baby Please Don't Go. How did that go? Jeez, it's been that many years, probably 30 years since I sung that. Baby, please don't go. Baby, please don't go. Baby, please don't go down to New Orleans. You know, I love you so. Baby, please don't go. Won't be your dog. I won't be your dog. I won't be your dog. I wanna be your dog. Baby, please don't go. I love you so. I love you so. I love you so. You never, never know how much I love you so. Baby, please don't go. Don't you head away. Don't you head away. I can't make you stay, I can't make you stay. Don't head away, don't head away. Please don't go, baby, please don't go. Don't you head on down in New Orleans. Baby, please don't go, because I love you so. I won't be your dog, I won't be your dog. Don't treat me mean, you don't treat me mean. I won't be a dog, I won't be a dog. Baby, please don't go, baby, please don't go. Don't you head on down to New Orleans, baby, please don't go, baby, please don't go. Kenny would play guitar, I'd play the harmonica on that one. We were playing that song once in a hospice. There's one old bloke out the back, and I said to the nurse, wheel him in, he's missing out the music. She said to me, he can't hear anything, he's brain dead, he's been here for a few years, he can't move anything other than his little finger. I said, he can move his little finger. She goes, yeah. So we kept on playing music and I kept on watching this little finger because that's the only thing apparently it could move. And you know what? That little finger was beating in time. Nobody noticed that except me. So I said, stop. When I got the nurse and said, that bloke can feel the music. He's in time with his little finger. She says to me, not possibly, he's brain dead. I said, watch his little finger. We started playing again, everybody was watching him and his little finger didn't do anything. It made me look like a bullshit artist. But on playing and people stopped watching him, and after a while his little finger started to go again, and luckily the nurse looked up and saw it. They were gobsmacked, so they wheeled him straight in front of us, and from that day onwards they always treated him like he knew everything that was going on because they thought he was brain dead. Music is the gateway to the soul, to the brain. It's the audio, the whole audio processes are connected up with the physical processes, everything's connected up, so music also connects us up, and it's taught me a lot over the years. Anyway, Kenny Aykroyd's funeral is on this Wednesday and I'm going there. I'm showing my respect to Kenny, but also to meet all the old friends that used to hang out with him. He taught us so much, Kenny. He was an interesting man, very, very talented artist, and bigger than life. Mrs. Kenny.
That there's the house my mum used to live in Reefton. Gonna go knock on the door and ask the people home if I can have a look around. Did you build that too?
We
out there?
We built all that out there. We've done everything that's been done on the place.
Bloody clever bugger. Yeah. Yeah, fireplace, Pioneer. Jeez, yeah. It looks good. Yeah. That's the original roof.
Yeah.
It's original ceiling.
Yeah, that's original.
I think you might be right. Gee, the kitchen looks nice, mate. That's a good idea.
Yeah.
You've done all that in just plywood and varnished it.
That's black pine. That came from the Whanganui River down south.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah.
This gives me an idea because I'm building a new kitchen where I live. This is brilliant, mate.
Yeah.
So. You know what? A bit of imagination goes a long way, eh? Like a bit of creativity goes a lot further than money.
That's right, eh? Yeah,
you've got a lot of creativity, eh?
That would have originally been the wash house.
Oh, yep. Have you right?
In behind there, there's a concrete wall that goes along, and that's a part of it there. And originally when it was built, there was that room, the hallway, and that room through there.
Right.
Then they, because they had family this out, they built the sunroom thing on out there.
Right, like they used to in those days, they add on.
Yeah.
Shit, bedroom, I'm
yeah,
pretty sure.
Yeah, this was the main bedroom.
Yeah, this is where Mum used to sleep in here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is this where your son sleeps now, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Eh?
Son sleeps here, grandson in here.
Oh, okay, get the wee sunroom.
Yeah.
Well, there's a lot of sun. That's cool. Jesus, Ty, you've done a bloody good job, mate. I love this. This is brilliant.
Yeah. Well, we're going to rip this wall out.
Nah, this is great. I was driving down the street here in Reefton, and I drove past the old house my mum used to live at. I wanted to see what it looked like, and when I looked over the fence, it just looked so amazing. Like, this bloke that's moved in here, he's planted all these natives on the outside, and he's painted it. He's just shown me right through the house now. It's really, really interesting. His name's John. But also, he knows a bit about horses, and I want to just pan up here and show you guys. This is New Zealand's most famous horse. The Aussies kind of stole it from us a bit, eh, John?
That's Farlap. Farlap was actually originally born in Tamaru, and that's how he got his name, through the Farlap Raceway. And that's what Tamaru's called.
Right.
And he was sold to the Australians, and the story was that he actually never got paid for something.
Is that right?
Yeah, he took it to Australia. There was a big row over him when he went to Australia. But he turned out he was the top bloody galloper out there. Won the Melbourne Cup and a lot of other cups. And the heart of it, his heart was actually twice as big as a normal horse's heart.
Yeah, they keep the heart somewhere, don't they? Like, they've got it in a place store somewhere.
The biggest heart ever. I think it's about 14 pounds or something, the average horse's heart.
Have you ever seen it? They still got it, eh?
No, but I've got, they actually got the book on him in there too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
So where'd you get this picture from? This must be quite a valuable picture.
The bloke had it hanging up in his shed.
Yeah?
And it never had a frame or anything, just on a piece of cardboard like it is now.
Right.
And I went cooking him one day. I said, you realise, I said, that's probably one of our best bloody horses we ever had that the Aussies stole from us.
Bloody Aussies, eh?
Yeah. And I said, you know, you should be shot for leaving that hanging in the shed like that. Well, anyway, turned out one Christmas, we went there for his tea and that. And old Ron said, here, I got something for you. So anyway, he handed me the photo.
Gave it to you?
He gave it to me. So anyway, yeah, I give it to my daughter and she cleaned it all up and repainted it and got it all looking bloody good again. So
wow.
So when he comes round now, he looks at the photos. Yeah, I'm just a mongrel.
Yeah, bloody good.
But it's a beautiful horse. It was really, really, they actually killed it. The Aussies actually killed it by over racing it.
Really?
Yeah, they burnt the guts out of it. They really, really did. Yeah.
Bugger.
So.
So tell us about this photo here, this trotter.
Yeah, but that's old Cardigan Bay. And,
Cardigan Bay.
Yeah, Cardigan Bay. Peter Wolfenden had Cardigan Bay and yeah. Used to drive it and race it and she was the top. Yeah.
What year would that be?
So that'd have to go back. Cardigan Bay would have been back in probably 70s, probably even yeah. Might have even been a bit before that, I think. I don't think there's any dates on there, I really don't know, right? But no. I honestly couldn't tell you what year it was.
154 starts, and she won 80 races, is that right, out of that?
She won 80, she had 154 starts.
Yep.
She won 80.
Yep.
25 seconds and 22 thirds, for a total prize of $1,237, is what she won, yeah.
And has she not been beaten since that day,
still? That record has never been beaten
right,
to this day.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
Well, it's bloody interesting, mate. I appreciate you taking the time. Thanks for that and showing us around the house. I love what you've done to it. Real creativity. Oh, mate, it's a working art, this place. It's nothing like it used to be, I can tell you that.
We're pretty lucky because a lot of stuff we get it either for nothing. A lot of this is all earthquake recovery stuff.
Yeah, but the thing is, you see, you've got the creativity and the imagination. Like I said to you before, imagination and creativity goes a lot further than money. People with a lot of money can have places that look like everywhere else.
That's right, they can go to the garden and do whatever they want, spend money. But this year, most of this number here is free.
Yep.
You know, people are going to chop up for firewood, rubbish or something. Doors here, these were given to us. This wall was actually just rotten and burnt out. There's actually been a fire under here.
Right.
Yeah, so they had fire set on it.
Got the nice little natives everywhere.
Yeah.
Balcony, you can have your coffee up there.
Yeah.
Old wheelbarrow painted up, garden all around. You have a few tuis come in the garden too here.
Okay.
You have a few tuis come in the garden.
So we get a few come around,
yeah.
Yeah.
No, she's nice.
Down beside you, we've got
a few shots. My mum's going to be rapt to see this, she really is. Hey, I've got to bugger off back to Nelson. Good to meet you.
That's all right.
See you later.
You're
thank you. How cool is that, eh? Really awesome. So nice to see an old house that was falling to bits actually brought back to something that's even nicer than it used to be. My mum will be rapt. See you, John. Got Carol on my travels. I just got home. There's my lovely daughter. There's my big boy. Just got home after 11 days away, I think. Don't know. I see the.
9 days.
Is it 9 days?
I think so, yep.
Thursday, what day is today?
Sunday.
Okay. Don't know. Anyway, a few days. I thought it was 11.
Okay.
I see the rat trap's gone off that Troy gave me. Is there a rat down there bottom? There's no rat in there.
Maybe it was real windy.
Yeah.
It was really windy.
It's had a few rats. I thought I was going to see a rat. Yeah. Was it?
A
lot of wind.
It snowed.
It snowed on Taka Hill?
Yeah.
Have you fed the chickens tonight, honey?
Yeah.
Hey, pup. Hey, pink. Haven't even eaten your tucker. Hey. G'day. How you going? Hey. Hey. Good dogs, hey. I better let Poe out the back. Yep, it's good to see dogs be home. It'll do, calm down, Lee, calm down, Pace. Calm down. Well, thanks for looking after the place while I was away, sweetheart.
Okay.
Yeah. Let the Poe out. Here she comes. Got a few plants in the back up the side of the road. They were growing where they were going to cut them down, so I saved them.
Nice.
Yeah, Poe's got her hackles up. Good girl. Good girl. A little bit funny, hey, back home. Look at her hackles. Who's that, Poe? Hey? Who's that, eh, Poe? Right, we'll sort dogs out and catch up with my daughter. We just got home and straight away, Poe nails a rat. How fast was that, eh? Good girl, Poe. Good girl. She beat all the little wild terriers to it. Is it a male or a female? Bloody hell, Poe, that was fast, mate. Good girl, Poe. You nailed it. Good dog. Bloody awesome to be back on the farm. Just a few days I've been away. There's a few changes. Get him behind. Pink. Pink, come. Get him behind. Good girl. Good dog. Wiggle. Oh, Bruno, trying to keep up those little. Easy. Pace is dominating. Yeah, you see all the blossoms have come out on the fruit trees over there since I've been away. And Harry, my neighbour's knocked out a whole lot more. There's a baby blackbird just flew right in front of me. So there'd be some baby birds everywhere. It's very apparent that springtime has arrived. See, like three rabbits just over there jumping. These apple trees have been knocked down. They were actually getting knocked down when I was here, but they hadn't done, I think they've done three rows, they've done four now. And what else? Place looking green. Pond has gone down a bit. So just it's great to come home. And I dream of owning this place. Well, not all of it because I don't get a small piece of land, but I dream of buying some off my landlord. I'm going to be talking to the bank next couple of weeks, but one of my mates has just died. Ken Ackwood, musician that I played with in my 20s. His funeral's in Christchurch on Wednesday. I've just got home, it's Sunday night, so I'm gonna get my shit sorted and get back down to Christchurch and pay my respects to
his family and to him, or his soul, and all my old mates. But I do love coming home. This is my home, this ground. The clay, the Mutiri clay, where I was born. And even though it was awesome where I was down south, it really is nice to be back. This is where I belong. I think we all need a place that we belong somewhere, don't we? It always feels like home to me, so. It's really important I try to buy this bit of land. I want to secure something for my children. A place for Dayla to always be able to stay with her house truck. And just have a future and a place that's certain. Well, I shot two rabbits down there a couple of weeks ago, and already there's like three more there. They just keep on coming, and they keep on eating up my plate. Good to be home. Anyway, yeah, this is my coming home vlog. Look at these guys, eh? Hey, B, you caught a rabbit 3 days ago, didn't you, mate, eh? I lent him to Patrick. Hey, Pink, here you go, mate. Did you miss me? Probably not. The pace has been with me the whole time. Bruno, you know you missed me, didn't you? Hell yeah. That's right, good dogs, good dogs, good dogs. But he's looking in good condition. Good pig dog. Yeah, looking awesome. So a slow two, I can see three rabbits over there. Two behind the pile, one with his head sticking up. Beautiful night, beautiful night. I love Nelson, eh? I love Tasman. I love this area. Listen to the birds. You can hear the native birds, and you can hear the introduced species like the blackbird and the thrush mixing up together. Fantail there. It's a whole mixture. The old native bird. I love the birds. I'm on a good buzz. I'm on a good buzz coming home. Feels good. The Highland cattle chilling out. Jeez, didn't think I'd be so happy to be home. It was good being away, but yeah, I'm pretty high on it, to tell you the truth. It's doing it for me. Coming home. Dogs are all happy. Good dogs, eh? Hey, you good boy. Wagging your tail. Good dogs. Good dogs. Right, well, I'm going to go and get the fire going. Start the big job of unpacking the truck. There's a shitload of stuff to unpack. I took rifles, fishing rods, dog equipment, tracking gear, drone, all the camera gear, food, two packs of different stuff, boots for the boys, for Cuzzy. I've still got his to drop off. Survival gear, safety gear, lamps, lights. I took four rifles in total. Ammunition, knives, fly fishing gear, sea fishing gear, GPS tracking gear, white baiting gear, a boat, outboard motor, spade, axes. This just goes on and on. The amount of stuff I took on the truck is a heap. I'm going to go now and take all the food out, so what I'm gonna do now, because I actually was anticipating there'd be more people to feed than I fed, and I overstocked. So there's a bit of food that's gonna probably go to chickens, and all the other stuff that's keep will go to me. Anyway, I'll stop yakking because I'm just talking rubbish now, and you don't want to hear that. Hey, Ducky, did you miss me? Hey, not for you, Pace. These are for Ducky. Hey, Ducky. Yeah, I gave another walk.
They've literally had four walks today.
What, the dogs have had four walks? Is that a bad thing?
I don't know, they're having a good time.
Yeah.
I gave them one when I first woke up, and then I was just hanging around the house. I was like, oh, I want to go to the beach. And I decided, okay, I'll just have dogs for me. Why
not? Yeah.
Jumped in the cruiser.
So have you worked out what you were doing with the cruiser? Was I right? Did you drive it around in low box the whole time? What, have you driven it since
I drove it slowly.
You shouldn't drive it anywhere in low box, honey.
No, I had to drive it over here because I had to, I let my car battery die.
So,
used it to jump my car.
Okay. So, did you try and change the gearbox ratio on it?
I didn't have that.
It sounds like you've been driving around a four-wheel drive in low box.
I drove it slowly. Very slow.
Well, you would be driving slowly because low box. And it'd be over revving. And...
No, I kept it below 3, like 2.5.
I hope so.
It was 2.5 the whole time.
You're not even supposed to drive on the tower seal with it in four wheel drive.
No, I didn't know that.
Okay, let's get a look and see what's in low box, eh?
It is in low box, it will be.
Okay, we're gonna have a look. Where's the rat, Po? Where's the rat, hey? Where's it gone? Where's the rat, B? Where's it gone? Whole rat pack trying to find a rat. Poe's a rat master, ain't you, Poe? Where's a rat, Pink? Where's it gone, eh? Where's a rat? Where's a rat, Pink? Get a rat. Four dogs in a tight spot. Hey? Where's it gone, Poe? Where's a rat, eh? Where's a rat? Where's it gone, eh? Tail's wagging 100 mile hour. Where's it gone, eh? Good kill! You smashed it, didn't you? Actually, Poe got that. Poe got it, and then Pink stole off Poe, didn't you? And she's got it again. Good kill! Well done. The Nissan Fairlady Z. The last time I was on this car was 5, 6, 7 months ago. As you can see, she's been sitting for a long time and she's covered in shit. And she's in bad repair. This was gifted to me temporarily while I was going through my treatment for cancer. I had a lot of driving to do around the country, MRI scans, bloods, doctor's appointments, surgeon's appointments, on and on. And somebody who's wanting to remain anonymous but supports my channel and supports what I do said, don't keep on clocking all the K's up on your Hilux, mate. It's too valuable a car. And offered me 15 grand to buy something to go and get all my treatments and run around. That's exactly what I bought was this. Probably not the right choice. So the sensor broke on the engine, and I haven't driven it since. When I got home, it just didn't start anymore. And good bastard Daniel came around just about an hour ago. He's a mechanic and he fixed it up for me. We're gonna crank this beast up. I have to give it back at some stage to the dealers once I was cancer free. It's got to go back to him, and I called me the other day. I said, I've had all my tests and right now I'm cancer free. I'm a well person again. So he said, you can drive it for this the next month or two if anything comes up you need it. And I just called him last night and said, hey, your mate Ken's died and I need to go to his funeral. He said, take it. So she's running. I'm not really a sport car person, but it's really handy for doing those fast trips, because from here to Christchurch it's about 4 or 5 hours, you know, 5 hours comfortably, so. And it goes like stink. Hell yeah. Bad whiskey. Bad whiskey. Bad whiskey made me lose. Well, I'm in Linwood in Christchurch, and as you can see, there's just hundreds and hundreds of cars. This Kenny was a well-known musician. Heaps of people come in to pay his respects. And I'm really pleased I made the trip from Christchurch to come down here. I'm sure I'm going to bang into a lot of old mates. I'll come out of the woodwork. A lot of old musicians.
Baby, please don't go. Baby, please don't go. Baby, please don't go down to New Orleans. You know I love you so. Baby, please don't go. Won't be your dog. I won't be your dog. I won't be your dog. I wanna be your dog. Baby, please don't go.
What's gonna happen, Pacey?
Do you like?
Can happen here. Yeah. Will they catch the pig pace? Will they catch it? Hey, they're gonna catch it. That fella is a Highland cattle, and he lives a bloody good life. My landlord owns him. He's a pet. Imagine having enough money you can actually afford to have a pet bull.
Generally, when you've got livestock, you've got dead stock. I mean, I eat everything I grow. Hey, anyway, yeah, welcome back. I'm back. Well, I haven't done a snap vlog in nearly 3 weeks. Did I miss being offline? Because there was no internet. Well, actually, there was, but I never used it when I was down there. There's a place I've got it now in Bruce Bay, but I didn't know it was there until the end. But did I miss it? Not even a little bit. I really didn't. I didn't miss having to do all the work I do, and it was just like a break. Not to say I don't enjoy making snap vlogs, because I do. I actually enjoy making videos, but when I don't make them, I enjoy that too. Make any sense? Anyway, back at the farmhouse, got a shitload of stuff to open. Gifts that people have left for me, or sent me. And on that note, if you're going to send me something, please only do it if it's within your means, because sometimes I just, it amazes me what people send me, and I think, well, what about your own family and your own children? So, thank you very much. I'm saying a thank you in advance because I don't quite know what's going to be in there, but I'm always a wee bit overwhelmed by that. I am going to give this girl here, Pink, I've decided that Pink is going to go to Sneak. Sneak's a pig hunter on the North Island. He's a Patreon, belongs to the GBC, he's a good bastard. And even though I bought him myself and got her to 7 months old and done all the work, I've decided to gift to this guy for a number of reasons. Firstly, he's been a massive support to my channel. Secondly, he offered me his main pig dog when my hunting was going crap over a year ago. He said, listen, mate, you can have it. And I was like, well, I'll come right, mate, because I was just in a shift, you know. I'd lost Choppy and things were a bit up and down. Now it's settled, but just the fact he was going to give me his main dog. So I'm going to give something back. And we're going to hopefully catch up with Sneak. He's going to come and stay here. And that'll be something we can sort of watch and see how the dog goes, because these little wild terriers are great dogs. They really are. They're crackers. And she's a lovely girl. She won't give me any problems. She doesn't trail bark. Over here in the duck pond, we had some fledglings. I can't even see them here now. I'll find them later on and show you. But she had like 12 or 13 ducklings, and that was 3 days ago. Now she's only got 4 or 5. Bloody pukekos. They just kill them, eh? The hawks and the pukekos. It's just heart-wrenching. We don't get any fledglings that last on the pond here. That means during duck seeding season there's nothing to eat. My intentions aren't all that good, but I would like to see them survive long enough to at least grow up big enough to go on someone's plate. Well, as you can see, it's springtime. This place is just fucking amazing to be home. Just amazing. Absolutely beautiful. And my intention is to own a bit of land here. I'm talking with my landlord. I've got two plans. I've got plan A and plan B. Plan A is I go back to Europe from a tour, because the way I make money, or can really make real money, is by performing music, like seriously. Believe it or not, I can actually sing. I couldn't feel, so I tried to touch. I've told the truth, I didn't come to fool ya. And even though it all went wrong, I stand before the Lord of Song with nothing on my tongue but hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Channel are just like funny ones and humorous, but I was a professional singer in Germany for 13 years, and that's still open to me to go back, and I can make a lot of money doing that. Don't really, really want to. Mind you, once I get over there, I'll probably enjoy it, but it will give me a chance to get some money to buy a bit of land here. There's 30 acres here, and the landlord will cut off a section for me, he said. It'll be the section that's got the native bush in where the farmhouse is, and eventually I'll own my own home. If I don't raise that money and can't do that and make it all work, someone else will buy it and I'll have to move out. And that's where plan B kicks into action. The houseboat, which I'm going to go out to very shortly to check on. But the houseboat would be also a great way to live, but it means I couldn't keep all the dogs. I maybe keep just Pace and Poe. And I want my own place.
I've been renting for 12 years and I want to have a place that's mine. I mean, look at it, all that native bush, that'll be part of the section. The old farmhouse needs a lot of work done to it. I mean, it needs a lot of work done. It needs to be insulated, it's cold, and I probably would build a log cabin here rather than try and do up the old house. But that's my plan, what I want to do. And I'll be taking you guys along for the journey, whatever happens. If I go to Germany, I'll take you over there. If I build a log cabin, I'll show that. However it comes, it'll be an epic adventure in itself. Right, I'll stop the yakking, go inside, and we'll see what I've been sent. Because I'm kind of excited. I mean, who isn't excited to open some parcels? I mean, it feels like bloody Christmas time every time I sit down with a knife and crank open what's there. See you in the house. Hey, mate. There we go, yeah. Some of those.
This song is for the craziest girl, Bruce Bay. Wajalina, have you seen her? Have you seen her? No, no. I said, Jalina, have you seen her? Yes, I've seen her. There she goes. She got big brown eyes and a great big smile, and she makes everybody's time worthwhile. What, Jalina, have you seen her? Jalina, she says some crazy, what do you mean?